Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the remaining part of lesson number 2, Cultural Heritage of India, Handicraft and Fine Arts. The following points are to be discussed today. Leather industry, diamond beadwork and enamel work, cherry work, metal work, wooden art, inlay work and acrylic work. Leather industry, skin of dead animals were used for various purposes since ancient time. After the death of animal, its skin was processed in a traditional manner. Leather was prominently used for making masak. Masak means a leather bag for taking water from the wells. Koos, drum, dholak and tabla. Dholak and tabla, they are the drum, dholak and tabla. They were the musical instruments. And bellows used by the blacksmith and various types of footwear. Different type of chappals also for making that leather was used. That leather belts to tie the animals. Around the neck, you can see that around the neck of a cat, that dog, etc., you can see the belt. They are also made from leather. Leather was also used to prepare shield, which was used during wars. So in ancient time, that the kings used to use that shield, and that shield also was made of leather. Leather industry had a prominent place in India since ancient time. Well knitted mojri of Rajasthan. Rajasthan is famous for mojri, and this mojri is also made from leather. Then shoes, leather knitted purses, then bells and other things also made from that leather for the animals like a horse and a camel, like a saj, palan and a lagam. Even whip for beating them, whip is used today. It is also made of a leather. So skin of the dead animals was used for various purposes in ancient time. After the death of animal, that their skin, its skin was processed in a traditional manner, and leather was used for making which things are that masak, koos, that musical instruments like a drum, dholak, tabla, bellows used by the blacksmith for making the footwear, leather belts to tie animals, etc. And mojri of Rajasthan is made from that leather. Even that for horse and camel also. Saj, palan and lagam, they are also made from leather. Then next topic is diamond beadwork and enamel work. India has 7,517 kilometers long coastline surrounding all three directions, east, west and south. So what is the length of India's coastline? 7,517 kilometers. And coastline of India has two coastline, west coastline and that east coastline. So these are diamonds and beads, they are available from the seawater. There has been a wide use of gems and diamonds since ancient times. Since ancient time, trade of diamond and beads was carried out through sea routes with different countries across the sea. Diamond studded ornaments have been great demand in foreign countries since long. And India was famous for these two diamonds, Kohinoor and Great Mughals. Indians were fond of wearing that diamond and beaded ornaments. In ancient time, rich and royal people used to wear diamond jewelry apart from gold ornaments. So that is about a diamond. So the diamonds and beads from where they are available from the seas and oceans. What is the length of India's coastline? 7,517 kilometers. And what are the uses of that diamond? It is used for making, that different types of ornaments, then thrones and crowns of kings. Which diamonds were famous in ancient time? That Kohinoor and Great Mughals. In ancient time, that which people used to wear this type of diamond ornaments, rich people and people from the royal families. The next one is that beads. beads also from where it is available from the seawater. So diamonds, rubies, beads, emerald and topaz were used to adorn. Adorn means decorate and beautify the thrones. Thrones means a simhasan, saying earlier that the rajas used to sit in their chair. That is also, that is called the thrones. And the crowns and the jewelry. Crowns means they used to wear that on their head, a mukut, saying that. And even it is beads were used for making that bracelet, garland, etc. of kings. And beadwork is also find prominent in Gujarat. The beautiful bead, thorns, paschit, pots, bari, chakra. Then during the time of marriage, they are making that coconut. Then indoni, modia, and these are all, means modia means a net cover, which covers the mouth of a bullock and horns. Then even hand fans, animal back cover, etc. are knitted in a quite artistic way. Now next one is that enamel work. Enamel work means the skill of inlaying bright colors like red, green and blue in gold and silver ornaments like rings, bangles, earrings, chains, etc. India was the only country in the world in the ancient time having experts in experience in enamel work. And expert in enamel work are in Jaipur, Delhi, Lucknow, Varanasi and Hyderabad. So what is the meaning of enamel work? The skill of inlaying bright colors like red, green, blue in gold and silver ornaments like rings, bangles, earrings, chain, etc. And which cities are famous for that enamel work? Jaipur, Delhi, Lucknow, Varanasi and Hyderabad. Now next one is a jari work. Jari work is seen in India since ancient times. Gold and silver threads are woven with the clothes and embroidery is done with the gold and silver threads to decorate the clothes. Surat is a prominent place for jari work. So which is it? Which place is famous for that jari work? That is Surat. And there are different types of jari work like knitting, embroidery, jardoshi work, etc. Even that means artisans of Surat, they could make beautiful dresses like a sari, then garchola, etc. that are bordered with the jari. So jari work, that means how they are making the jaris, means golden and silver threads are woven with the clothes and embroidery is done with the gold and silver that threads to decorate the clothes. And which city is famous for that jari work? Surat is famous for that is jari work. And then which are the different types of jari work? Ajar work, battikam and knitting and embroidery, jardoshi work. The next one is that metal work. Metal work is a very old form of art in India. That we know that metal age came after that stone age. And artisans of Lodhal, they made different weapons like a sickle, drill, needle, etc. with a copper and a bronze. Moreover, they also prepare utensils, idols and pots, then arms with that metals. Arms and ammunition for wars were also made of metal. Arms and ammunition means weapons used during the wars, they were also made of metals. And gold and silver, they were used for making the ornaments. Then copper, brass, bronze and iron were used to make utensils, idols and weapons. So, which is the old form of art, metal work. And the metal age, when it came after that, stone age. And which were the things made by the artisans of Lodhal by using that metals, sickle, drill, needle, etc. And they also prepare utensils, idols, and pots. Even that in ancient time during the wars, that different weapons were made. They were also made from that metals. That gold and silver, they were used for making different types of ornaments. And copper, brass, bronze, and iron were used to make utensils and idols. Then wooden art. Wooden art, there is a close relation between man, trees and forest. That in the beginning, that wood was used as a firewood. Firewood means for that jalane ke liye that they used a wood. Means later they started making different weapons and construction of buildings by using the wood. And gradually, wood was used for different purposes like making idols, toys for children, that the pillars, then windows, doors, small huts on the top of the terrace, thrones, chairs and grills. The swings and the toys of feather and wooden furniture of a Sankeda is in Gujarat are famous. So that there is a close relationship between man, trees and the forest. Earlier that what was the use of a wood? It was used as a firewood. Later they started making the weapons and buildings. For making the buildings, then that it was also used for making idols, toys for children, pillars, windows, doors, small huts on the top of the terrace, thrones, chairs, grill, etc. And the sphinx and the toys of feather and the wooden furniture of Sangi. Inlay work. What do you mean by inlay work? The process of fitting diamond, pearls, rubies, etc. and gold and silver ornaments like a necklace, bracelets, nose rings, crowns, etc. is called inlay work. And it is considered to be, inlay work is considered to be the very ancient art of India. And the Bikaner area of Rajasthan is famous for inlay work. Artisans were expert in the work of inlay art. So what is meant by inlay work? The process of fitting diamond, pearls, rubies, etc. and gold and silver ornaments like necklace, bracelets, nose rings, crowns, etc. is called inlay work. And it is considered to be the very ancient art of India. In objectives, they will ask which work is considered to be the very ancient art of India, inlay work. Then which area is famous for inlay or ornaments? That Bikaner area of Rajasthan is famous for inlay ornaments. I showed here that inlay work. Then akik work. Akik means it is a kind of precious stone, valuable stone. Especially it is found in valley area of a river. And it is a chalcedonic. That means it is mixed with the silica, blue or white stone. And carnelian is the main stone with a semi-transparent quality and a beautiful red in color. In Gujarat, these various precious stones, they are available in big and small size at Ranpur and Surat. All these, so from where it is available at Ranpur and Surat. Then that stones are available from Surat and Ranpur. And then these stones, they are sent to Khambat. And where they are molded into, where they are making from this stone, they are making different ornaments of different designs. And beads and garland or stones are prepared by them. So write a short note on akik work. What is akik? It is a kind of precious stones. Where they are found? They are found in the valley area of a river. Then it is a chiefly chalcedonic mixed with the silica, blue or white stone. And where these akik stones are found, they are found in Surat and Ranpur. And these stones, then they are sent to Khambat to make it into different ornaments, beautiful ornaments with the designs. So today we have studied leather work, diamond, bead work and enamel work, jerry work, metal work, wooden art, inlay work, akik work. All these are different handicraft. Now next video I am going to explain you different art forms, music, dance, painting, then dramatic art, etc.